Mary Ann and Wanda were the best of friends all through their high school days. Both members of the 4-H club, both active in the FFA. After graduation, Mary Ann went out looking for a bright new world. Wanda looked all around this town, and all she found was Al. Well, it wasn't 2 weeks after she got married that Wanda started getting abused. She put on dark glasses, long sleeve blouses, and makeup to cover her bruise. Well, she finally got the nerve to file for divorce. She let the law take it from there. But Al walked right through that restraining order and put her in intensive care. Right away, Mary Ann flew in from Atlanta on a red-eye midnight flight. She held Wanda's hand and they worked out a plan, and it didn't take them long to decide that Earl had to die.
Na, 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 na.
Goodbye, Earl. Those black eyed peas, they tasted alright to me. You're feeling weak. They tipped their hats and said, "Thank you, ladies. If you hear from him, let us know." Well, the weeks went by, spring turned to summer, summer faded into fall. And it turns out he was a missing person who nobody missed at all. So the girls bought some land and a roadside stand out on Highway 109. They sell Tennessee ham and strawberry jam, and they don't lose any sleep at night, 'cause Earl had to die.